It's been about a year since Disney bought Marvel Comics. You know, we actually asked Tyson Dukes what he thought was going to happen a year ago when he was on our show, and we never aired it. So through the magic of television, you can see that right now.
To me, there's ups and downs, because any big franchise takes over anything, there's going to be cause and effect. In this case, I think, like he was saying, there's going to be like a lot of really cool like comics, there's going to be cool movies and all that stuff made, but the artistic expression and the creative control that would have made like stuff that you'd venture out with, like Deadpool and like those odd characters, are going to just kind of go sink down, going to be like a subpar to the, you know, pretty and bright Spider-Man mainstream and stuff. I don't dig it.
Danny, got it down here?
Yeah. I wrote down disagree.
Shake hands.
I only have to say one word. That's Pixar. Okay? The Pixar movies they make are phenomenal. And Pixar takes over and depicts Marvel from start to finish in perfection.
I haven't seen anything content-wise that's been drastic. However, most recent developments are the reduction in the price of the comics coming down by a dollar to $2.99 on the regular titles. So to me, that's the most significant change since Disney took it over. And it's probably, in some respect, trying to compensate for dramatic losses, let's say from sales of comics from the 70s, mm-hmm. when your top-selling books like Spider-Man were doing 600,000 copies when they were selling for 25, 35, 50 cents.
And how much are they selling now?
They're, you know, the regular books are around the $4 range. Now they'll be dropped to $3. So why did Disney buy Marvel? I don't know. To make money? They must be making money, but are they making the kind of money that you would hope if you're selling 600,000? Probably not.
Well, viewers, you can make fun of the comics from the 50s, 60s, and 70s as much as you want, but the fact is they sold 10 times as many copies as the comics are selling today, so they had to be doing something right.
Right. I agree with you.
Well, what always comes to mind when I think about it is just the thing they did about Miracle Man. And bringing him back. And what they've done with it was pretty good.
So far, they've only reprinted the 50s stuff, right?
Yeah, which was great.
All right, Disney buys Marvel 1 year later. What do you see?
Well, I see probably the big thing is exposure, more exposure to children for comics. One thing that's been on a lot of the comic book blogs that I've noticed is that they're selling the books now at Disney World in the shops that you know the kids can pick them up and read them. So if anything, it's helping to get the books back out to the kids and not just at a comic shop, and so they can read it and enjoy them.
Yeah, until Disneyland got those comics, yeah. It sucked. Boring.
1 year goes by. This is what I see, okay? I see Avengers number one, Secret Avengers number one, New Avengers number one, Avengers Academy number one, Avengers Prime number one. I see Wolverine the Best There Is number one, Wolverine number one. So I don't see much of a difference, but that's just me. So really, why did they buy Marvel? What have they done to improve Marvel? I would say nothing.
Okay. No, as we were saying before, yeah. I didn't notice, you know, Wolverine's in five different books. Continuity. Mm-hmm. I don't see any work on that. I hope that's what I was hoping for. Not just the stuff about the kids.
Yeah.
I do. Oh, they have some cool helmets, though. Like cool Iron Man helmets and stuff. But
you know what? Increase the page rates. Pay them more. Do something. Hire some good writers. Okay, so we're sitting here with the Honky Tonk Man.
No, you're not sitting. You're standing.
Standing. Okay. Is it true that you are the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time?
That's a matter of opinion, but I think I'm the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time. The greatest of all time. Yeah.
I still remember when you beat Ricky Steamboat. That's one of my favorite moments in wrestling history. That was great.
That was a great moment. That's one of my favorite moments, too. He didn't like it. He said he didn't like losing to an Elvis impersonator. But the question is, who would you rather lose to? A guy that carried a snake, a guy that had the bagpipes and had a dress on, or the biggest arms in the world? Oh, yeah, brother.
Do you still keep in touch with Jimmy, Mouth of the South Hart?
Not very often. The only time I can find Jimmy is when I see his feet sticking out of Hogan's backside. Comic book what?
Comic book syndicate assemble.
Who thought that fucking name up?
Not us.
I'm serious.
Not us.
This is a Honky Tonk Man, and you're watching and listening to Comic Book Assembled Syndicate. No?